3 weeks later. Hour later.
Hey, what's up YouTube? It's your boy Kimani and I'm here back again with another video for you guys today. And let's just say the time has come. It's been 4 whole months since your boy got a cut, and it's now time to see what we've been doing. So I made an appointment. It's now 1:35. It's now 1:35. I made an appointment for 2:30 at my barber shop. Just got ready. I'm a little bit overdressed, if you ask me, just a little bit. Because your boy's been in the house for 2 months, 3 months now. Haven't really gone out, so I got a chance, you know. Barbershops are open up. We gotta do a little something, you know what I'm saying? So y'all go on journey with me. We're heading to the barbershop. Might stop to get some coffee at Starbucks. Not sure as yet. We'll see how that goes. But yeah, let's just get right into it.
So yeah, guys, how could I forget to show y'all my outfit? So, you know, a nice little pink simple tee. Some black jeans, and on feet we got the Yeezy 700 V3s Oliver colorway, you feel me?
So yeah, guys, just made it to the car, about to head out. Actually a nice day outside, which is crazy that we got this COVID-19 shit going on, but don't worry, your boy got his mask, you know, we staying protected out here. Got some hand sanitizer, all that good stuff. So I'm gonna head to the barber right now, get my cut. Actually, before we head to the barber, we gotta stop by Starbucks, because you know we gotta get that coffee. I just woke up like 2 hours ago. It is 2 o'clock right now, so yeah, I got 30 minutes to get to the barber. So when I get there, I'll let y'all know what's going on. See you in a few. So yeah, guys, not only did Starbucks like have a crazy ass line, it looked like I was gonna have to wait for like 20-30 minutes, which I don't have the luxury of being able to do that, because I got an appointment at 2:30. So I'ma just have to hold on a sec. Yeah, I'ma just have to wait until after I get my cut or whatever. But yeah, so I'll see you guys when I get to the barbershop. Trying to stay focused on these streets, you know, New York is crazy. So I'll catch y'all in a bit. Peace. First off, guys, this is probably my third time making this video right here. Just this part of the video. Probably my third time recording it. I've been getting phone calls back to back. And me with my stupid ass forgot to put my phone on airplane mode so I don't get disturbed while I'm making the video. So, let's try this again. Now, I strongly deserve a congratulations, you played yourself. It's a whole story. I'm gonna take you through it right now, okay? So, as we all know, it's quarantine time. Well, the quarantine has been, you know, it's been slowly lifting up. And at the same time, things are getting better slowly, right? So, I've been woofing my hair. I'm a waver. I've been waving since last year, summer. And I've been woofing my hair since January, right? It's been 4 months. It's been a 4 month wolf going to 5 months, and I've been wolfing my hair. Now, just before this quarantine thing started, I was already wolfing, right? Because, you know, wolfing to get my my waves defined and my connections good and all that good stuff, right? So I've been waving for a minute now. When the quarantine started, it happened like that. So I didn't even get time to say, okay, let me cut my hair before this quarantine starts, because I don't know how long it's gonna last. So it happened like this. Barbershops were closed all over the country, basically. And I had to just, you know, try to maintain it. All this time passes and it's now April, and they say that about May 15th, they're gonna start opening up back businesses little by little, whatever, right? I said, cool, I'm gonna have to maintain this till May 15th. I should be able to do that. I checked the website, my barbershop website, to see the appointment schedules and all of that. Everything was closed until May 15th. So the shops were closed until May 15th and there was no available appointment slots, right? May 15th, there was slots open onward. So I said, okay, I'm gonna watch it. When the time gets closer, I make an appointment. Yesterday, May 15th pops up. I say, okay, here we go. I'm gonna make an appointment. So I go on the website, check, slots are open. I was like, all right, great. Made an appointment for today, May 16th, because yesterday it was too late. It was like an hour before the shop would have closed. So it didn't make any sense. So I made an appointment for today at 2:30. Woke up this morning at about 11:30 thereabout. Put in a good brush session, right? Brush, 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 comb, 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 brush, brush, brush. Put on my do-rag, got dressed, got ready, and everything. It was about 1:30, I got a notification, right? I came in the car, I got a notification that says your appointment is in an hour. I was like, okay, good. I'm about to head out shortly because I got to drive all the way to the shop, da, da, da. So I got a notification, it came down as a banner. Now, the thing with iPhones is, if someone sends you multiple texts, so 2, 3, 4, no matter how much text they send you, when the banner comes down, it's only going to show you the first one, and you won't know if you got any more messages followed afterwards, unless they came, like, unless you swiped up and then another one came. But I didn't swipe up because I was in the car, I was ready to drive off and all that, so I wasn't really focused on paying attention to the text. I just know that normally they send you a message saying your appointment is in an hour, so I said, okay, no problem. Now that guys, is where I went wrong. So I drove all the way to my barber shop, right? It's like at the border of Manhattan and Brooklyn. So I drove all the way here, about a 25-30 minute drive. I got here, drove up, the shutters are down, the shop is closed. I'm saying to myself, what is going on here? That doesn't make no sense. I then go to my text message where they send me the reminder saying that my appointment is in an hour. Checked it, the second message came in. Remember, the banner only showed me the first one. The second message, which literally came in right after, it says, your appointment has been canceled for May 16th at 2:30. So, I deserve one of these. I really deserve one of these.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Now I'm here, stuck with my dick in my hand, because I did not read the freaking message. And I'm tight. I'm really tight right now because I got dressed, got all, you know, niced up, whatever. You know, put on some cologne, feel nice, you know. Did a little bit of overdressing because, you know, I put on a nice new shirt, some jeans, which I don't normally do, and one of my new sneakers just to feel nice because I haven't been out of the house in a minute, right? So you can't blame me for trying to look fresh, you know, trying to look a little bit nicer for coming out of the house. And now it's all in vain. But as I said before, guys, just stay safe out there. And if you ain't got to come outside, don't come outside. But anyways, guys, it's your boy Kimani. Thanks again for watching. Go ahead and like this video. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you can become a part of the notification family. Anyways, comment down below. Tell me how stupid I am for actually believing that the barbershop would be open, even though they finessed me. But comment down below, how stupid do you think I am? Comment down below if you think that I should have just waited it out. Comment down below if you've made it this far in the video, a bunch of L's. Just put a bunch of L's. Give me 3 to 5 L's if you've reached this far in the video. Anyways, guys, thanks again for watching. Go ahead and follow me on Instagram if you haven't already, at @trapwillprovide_, and on Twitter at @trapwillprovide. It's your boy Kimani, and I'm out. Peace. Dice is on the beat.